Good afternoon, and today is our 17 lectures, and we will start by the example in the PowerPoint, and later I will show you on the problem that we already have seen lecture number 15. Let me start over here. We are going to analyze the task. The task over here is a kind of statically indeterminate task, and the task has the pin, and pin support. And you want to use the matrix displacement method to analyze this task, and by using the matrix displacement method, that means we will start by determining the unknown displacement, and then later we will determine the reaction, and the last of that we will determine the force in the task member. The problem, given that all the tasks has the same axial stiffness of 120,000 meters square times kilonewton per meter square, and the task subjected to the force of 20 kilonewton, and also the downward settlement of 1 millimeter, and that occur at the node number 2. Where is the node number 2? Node number 2 is over here, okay? And we have 3, 4 nodes. So we have number 1, we have number 2, we have number 3, and we have number 4 nodes over here. Each node have 2 degree of freedom. So the total of our task gonna have total of 8 degree of freedom. Now, let us consider this one following the step that we already discussed. First, talking about the global coordinate. Where is the global coordinate? Let's put it at the node number 1, like this one. After you set up the global coordinate system, or in short, global coordinate system, you will know the coordinate of the node or of the joint. And that means over here, you're going to have 0 and 0. See, if this is 0 and 0, then on the node number 2, you move to the left for 1.2, and then you move up for 1.2. So the coordinate over here going to be minus 1.2 and plus 1.2, as shown over here. And then if you move to node number 3, node number 3 is in the left-hand side, 1.2 kilometer from the origin. So the coordinate of this node is going to be minus 1.2, 0. Okay, just minus 1.2, 0. And the last one, you move to the left for 1.2, and then you move downward for 0.9. So that is going to be minus 1.2 and minus 0.9. The coordinate is important for what? The coordinate is important to determine the length, to determine coordinate direction cosine lambda sub x, and coordinate direction cosine lambda sub y. Okay, and then for the node number, we have discussed about it. How about the member number? We have 3 members. Member number 1, member number 2, and member number 3. It's going to be the number and have a square enclosures. And then we come to the important thing, local coordinate system. We have 3 members. We have 3 local coordinate system. 1 is going to be over here, and in this direction. We have the second in this direction, and then we have the third member in this direction. We know the direction of the task member. Local coordinate, you may call it LCS. It is important because it's associated with some important thing about the sign of the coordinate direction cosine. For example, if Ajahn said, we have the member in this direction, and then this is plus X, this is plus Y. So you have positive lambda sub X and positive lambda sub Y in this direction of the task member. And then if you have the task member putting in this direction, this is minus X, this is minus Y, you get minus lambda sub X and minus lambda sub Y. Knowing the sign of coordinate cosine help you to check whether your calculation is correct or not. And again, if this the task member, this is in this direction, you will know you have minus lambda sub X and positive lambda sub Y. Okay, this is for member number one actually, and this is going to be in accordance to member number three. Okay, you know, member number one minus lambda X, positive lambda Y. Member number three minus lambda X and minus lambda Y. And if we have another member of the task putting in this direction, you have positive lambda sub X according to this one, and then negative lambda sub Y. Four important thing. And there are another four important thing. If you have the task putting in this direction, let me put this one in this color, in this positive X direction, you will get lambda sub X equal to 1 and lambda sub Y equal to 0. In the examination, if you have this kind of member, you don't need to do any calculation. Just write lambda sub X equal to plus 1, lambda sub Y equal to 0. And then if you have the member in this direction, that's going to corresponding to this member number two. You don't need to do the calculation. You said lambda sub X is minus 1. Lambda sub Y is going to be 0. Okay, just in the opposite. And then if you have the task in member in this direction, so you have lambda sub X equal to 0 and lambda sub Y equal to positive 1. In the opposite direction, in this direction, you have lambda sub X equal to 0 and lambda sub Y equal to minus 1. I'm asking you to remember or understand all of this thing about the coordinate direction cosine based on local coordinate system. Now we finish 1.4. We move to the more important thing, 1.5. The degree of freedom specified into two types. One, we have what so called the unconstrained degree of freedom. It is a kind of free degree of freedom. That's going to be the degree of freedom of this one and also of this one. Okay. And then you have another thing called the constraint degree of freedom. The constraint degree of freedom is going to be what? It's going to be at the support. here, here, and here. And then you have degree of freedom of this one to be 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7, 8. And for the unconstrained degree of freedom, you have degree of freedom number 1 and number 2. This step is very important step. If you did wrong classification of the degree of freedom, your process of calculation going to be wrong. Now, let me move to what we know on this one. We know Q sub K. This is going to be the applied force. The applied force going to be what? The applied force going to be occur at this unconstrained degree of freedom. And then we know another thing that we know about capital D sub K. Capital D sub K going to be the known degree of freedom at the support, okay, including the downward settlement at node number 2, node number 2 in this direction. Now, we will start to determine capital D sub K and also capital Q sub K. Now, for capital D sub K again, we have the downward settlement over here for 1 millimeter. And this downward settlement corresponding to the degree of freedom number 4. So our degree of freedom is going to be this one, going to be D3. And this one going to be D4. This one going to be capital D5, capital D6, capital D7, and capital D8. Most of the time, you don't need to write the capital D because all of the number over here indicate the degree of freedom already. So you don't need to actually to write those kind of things. Just put it in this kind of matrix. This one called what? This one called column matrix. Okay, the matrix like this one, we call it column matrix. And then we have known application, apply forces. It's going to be at the node number 1 and the node number 2, Q sub K. Going to be at the node number 1. There is no loading over here. So over here is 0. Over here, we have 20 kilonewton, but it's point downward, opposite to the degree of freedom number 2. So we have Q sub K again in the form of column matrix, only 2 member, 0 and minus 20. This is very important to identify the positive or negative of both applied loading and the displacement. And now we start to move to the third to the fourth step. We determine small k matrix. That's going to be member global stiffness matrix, small k. You got to write it for each member. We have 3 member. So we're going to have small k matrix, 3 of them. Now, the member number 1 is over here. Member number 1 has the near end over here. This is going to be near end. This is going to be far end. Okay. And then based upon this one, we know the coordinate of this one to be near end, 0, 0, far end, minus 1.2 and plus 1.2. So based upon this one, x sub f minus x sub n. This is going to be this one minus this one. That's going to be minus 1.2 minus 0. It's going to be minus 1.2. Okay, that's going to be also represent the length of this one, and also for y sub f minus y sub n. This is y sub f minus y sub n. This is y sub f. This is y sub n is equal to 2 minus 0. So it's going to be 2. Okay, meter actually. The length. Oh, I'm sorry. That's going to be 1.2. Okay, 1.2. This is 1.2 minus 0. This is going to be 1.2 meter. And this is going to be minus 1.2 meter. The length of this member is going to be the light blue square plus the green square. It's going to be square root of this one, square of this one, plus the square of this one, and then the sum of them, putting in the square root, is 1.697. Again, in this direction, lambda sub x going to be negative. Lambda sub y is going to be positive. That's going to be in our mind. Okay, and then for lambda sub x, we use this light blue, and that is going to be minus 1.2 minus 0 and divided by the length. You got it to be minus as we discussed over here. And another one, lambda sub y is going to be this term 1.2 minus 0 divided by the length L. You got this one to be positive. Now, to write the small k matrix, you got to know the degree of freedom. That's gonna be 3, 4. That's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4. And again, all of the task members have the same AE. Okay, the problem specified AE gonna be 120,000. You can keep AE as the unknown first, and then you move L over here. Just put it, divide it in every term. Okay, so the first one is gonna be this term square divided by L. Okay, so you get this term, this one square divided by L. And then the second important term, this is going to be lambda sub y square divided by this term. And then the third, you just multiply them. Now, you multiply negative by positive, you got to get negative over here. And divided by L, you get this one. Then you do the copy from this term to this term. You have the first set of your result. Then after you get the first set of your result, you do the copy of this one and then put the four member, the four coefficient over here. And then you reverse the sign from positive to negative. Okay, from negative to positive, and from negative to positive, and from positive to negative, then you get the third partition of this one. After you get the third partition, you just copy the third partition and put it back over here. Then you get small k1 matrix. Now, move to member number two. For the member number two, you have the term over here, x sub f minus x sub n. Where is it? This is 0, 0. This is minus 1.2. It's going to be minus 1.2 minus 0. It's going to be minus 1.2 meter. And then for x y sub f minus y sub n. This is going to be y sub f this is y sub n is going to be 0. So lambda sub x is going to be minus 1. Lambda sub y is going to be 0. You may prove it easily. Okay. The L is going to be this term square plus this term square. And again, it's going to be 1.2 meter as we know from the previous member. Now, lambda sub x, again, is going to be minus 1. Lambda sub y going to be 0. The degree of freedom is going to be this is near n, this is far n, actually 1, 2, 5, 6. Then we have the degree of freedom 1, 2, 5, 6. Whenever you get the member in the horizontal direction and in the vertical direction, the small k matrix is going to have a lot of 0 in the matrix. Now, we start over here. This is going to be lambda sub x squared divided by 1.2. You got to actually this one minus by 1.2. And this is 0 squared minus by 1.2, also 0. And then lambda sub x times lambda sub y is going to be 0, even though it's going to be divided by 1.2. So you get 4 member of them, then the partition here will copy to be partition over here. And then you just put the negative, okay, change the sign. And then you put everything over here. And then you copy it to this position. Then that is small K2 matrix. And then the third is over here with this direction. You know, lambda sub x gonna be negative. Lambda sub x gonna be negative. Lambda sub y gonna be negative also. Based on this one, you have know that this is going to be the length. Okay, varying the coordinate. This is 0, 0, and this is minus 1.2 x sub f minus x sub n. You get this one to be minus 1.2 meter. And then you have this one also, the red over here. This is going to be y sub f minus y sub n. This is going to be minus 0.9 minus 0. It's going to be minus 0.9 meter. Then put the square, put this one square, and sum them, take the square root, it's going to be 1.5. Now, lambda sub x is going to be minus. Minus what? Minus 1.2 divided by 1.5. And for the lambda sub y, you're going to have this one minus 0.9 divided by 1.5. You get both of them to be negative, as you may know about it. Now, the degree of freedom is going to be this is near n and this is far n, 1, 2, and 7, 8. Okay, 1, 2, 7, 8. And then you have the first one, this square divided by 1.5. You have this term. And then you have what? Second term, this square going to be positive, divided by 1.5. You get the second term to be positive. And then the third term, you just do the multiplication of these two, negative and negative, gonna provide positive. And then it's divided by 1.5, you get 0.32. Copy it over here. Do it again after finish this one. Just copy this partition, put over here, and then reverse the sign in front of it to be negative and then copy it put it over here after you get the third you get the fourth partition over here now you have the total of three small k matrix you got to put it in a big picture called structure stiffness matrix capital k matrix in short how to do it we going to do the indexing we going to put this small k into the capital k matrix how many degree of freedom do we have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 so capital k matrix gonna be 8 by 8 now we gonna put all the k small k matrix over here how to do it indexing how to do indexing mark the low first you're gonna be low number one and then you take this one over here 1 1 and then this one 2 and then this one 3 and then this one 4 mark it to low number one and then for the low number two do the same thing put this one to low number two put this one to low number two put this one to low number two and put this one over here then on the third row you may take this yellow on the third okay this is going to third row so the third row and then column number one and then column number two and then column number three and then column number four the last one you have column number four over here again put this number over here put this number over here put this number over here and put this number over here don't forget you have the AE in front of it AE okay and then we finish the small k one matrix into the capital K and then let us move to the next one we gonna check this one K2 okay K2 this is row number one check this one this is one this is gonna be 0.83333 then number two that's gonna be zero then number five minus 0.83333 and three and then you put zero over here that for row number one now for row number two zero 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 and then zero okay and then go oops sorry that is wrong that's not correct 5 5 6 that's going to be 5 6 that's wrong that's not correct you got to go this one for 5 and 6 and then row number 5 you come over here start with 1 minus 0.83333 and then second 0 and then positive 0.83333 and then 0 put it over here okay the last one number 6 you just put 0 0 0 0 you will see all of this number in yellow okay 1 2 5 6 row number 2 1 2 5 6 row number 5 1 2 5 6 and row number 6 1 2 5 6 now we move to another one that's going to be this one start with row number 1 and this is going to put it over here okay and this is going to put it over here and this is for 7 and this is for 8 then we have the second row that's row number 2 and row number 2 this is going to be here this is 2 going to be here and this is 7 and this is going to be 8 Okay, just put the number into the slot and then move it to row number 7. Row number 7 is where? Row number 7 is over here. Take this one, put 1. This 2, put 2. This is going to be 7. Okay, and this is going to be 8. Okay, and then we have another one of this one. Let me put it. This is number 8. This term 1, this term 2, this term 7, 7, and this term gonna be 8. Everything gonna put together, and then we have all of them at the same position. And then you got to check for symmetry of the matrix. Okay, after you combine them together, you got to check symmetry. How to check the symmetry? You just take this row 1, column 2, gonna be the same as this row 2, column 1. Okay, the same gonna be check for this one, check for this one, check for this one, check for this one. Hey, that's gonna be the same number, right? Yes, it's gonna same number for all of this. This one, and this one, and this one, and this one. Then you get this one and this one. This called symmetry. Okay, you got to check to make sure everything is okay. And for this two number, this two number, this one, this one, this one, and then for zero, you get this way. You will make sure your matrix, your capital K matrix, is a correct one. And this one, and then this zero, and then this zero, zero, zero. And the last one, you also require to check this one and this one. Hey, this is going to be symmetric matrix, okay? And also, you can see this matrix is 8 by 8. It's also for square plus symmetric matrix. All the steps of this is for checking our procedure is doing correctly or not. Now, since the small k, K1, K2, and K3 has EI, sorry, had EA in front of it. So don't forget about AE here. And also don't forget about AE here. And you know, it's 120,000. Now, you may put this number to time it. I prefer to do so. I don't like to have 12,000 in front of it. Most of the time, I just push all the number time 120. Now, we got to do the partition. We have this small q sub k, only q1 and q2. So we got to do the partition. And that's gonna corresponding to what? That's gonna corresponding to this one, d sub u. That's gonna be this one and this one. And also, you have what? You have this one for the reaction. Reaction is what? Reaction is going to be small q sub u. This one is going to be the reaction. And now, you got to partition it over here to separate the matrix. And the last one, you got to have this one to be d sub k. You know d sub k, you know q sub k. Now, you got to determine d sub u. We call this one k11, this one k12, this one k21, and this one k22. Now, if you do that, q sub k equal to q sub k equal to k11 times D sub U K 1 1 time D sub U and K 1 2 time D sub K okay now you may see that this going to provide us the result because you can multiply K sub 1 2 directly to the D sub K so put it in anyway this is gonna be Q sub K minus K 1 2D sub K and then that's gonna be equal to this term K 1 1 D sub U now just inverse it D sub U gonna be the inverse this term this term this term K 1 1 inverse is equivalent to 1 over K 1 1 the same thing okay that's gonna be inverse you know how to invert the matrix in your calculator sure okay the inverse of the matrix must be square matrix okay only square matrix can invert okay and now after you do the multiplication you get the result okay and then you have d1 equal to positive hey that's mean what that's mean this one d capital d1 positive and capital D2 negative okay capital D1 is going to be here capital D2 is going to be here so the result is going to be this matrix you have the new node number 1 over here and over here don't forget we have the settlement okay now we connect the line together we get this one for the elastic curve of the task. And then you got to specify the value of your capital D1 and capital D2 displacement. And then next, Q sub U, okay, the reaction. The reaction is going to be equal to capital K21 times this one. Plus capital K 22 times this one, okay. And let me stop this one a little bit. I have a call. Okay. For the second session, we gonna determine the reaction again. We gonna have Q sub U equal to K 21 capital D sub U plus K 22 capital Q sub K. Okay. We have this one, and then. I would like to note one more thing about this term. Okay, now you can compute it easily. Just time this one to this one. And then for the second term, I have a note for this one. I have a note. What the note, Ajahn? Ajahn will tell you. And then for the second term, what is going to be the second term if you note it? If you do the multiplication of this one for the second term, this term will time zero. Okay. This term will time 0.001. And then the other term gonna be zero. So we have the first term of this one to be 120,000. And this term time zero. And that's gonna be minus 0.2946 times minus 0 times minus 0.005. Okay. Now, for the second term, do the same thing. We have this term times 0. And we have this term times this one. And the other, 0 times 0. And then the second time, you have 0.2946 and then time sorry this is one this is 0.001 now the third 0 time this one 0 time this one and this one time 0 and this one time 0 this one time 0 and this one time 0 you get 0 okay following this pattern the order okay, the order, you will see the important number gonna be the second column time 0.01. So the four coefficient over here going to time 0.001. So we have the last term to be the matrix look like this one. Okay, I mean for k 22 time this one d sub k, many times you don't need to put everything into your calculator. Thinking about that, you putting all of this to be the matrix and put it in your calculator is going to be taking a lot of times. But if you know this kind of short way to do the communication, to do the calculation, this one gonna help you a lot. Now, at the end, after you take this one and then you plus it with this one, you get the reaction. And what is mean for reaction? What mean for reaction? The first term, minus 2.69. This is corresponding to the force on this degree of freedom. And then that's going to be in the opposite direction. D4, going to same upward direction. D5, negative opposite direction. And D6, going to be 0. D7, okay, and then D8. Then after you finish all the calculation for the reaction, you got to check the equilibrium, okay? You got to check the equilibrium of the applied loading and the reaction. Following this one, summation of F sub X equal to this one. Okay, this one. If you said this is positive, then this is minus 2.69. And this is going to be minus 20.40. Okay, this is minus. This is minus. And then plus 23.04. You get what? Very close to zero is okay. Okay, this is going to be 2.69, 20.04, and this one, hey, yeah, yeah. And that is going to be equal to 9 and 0 and 23.09 minus and plus 23.04. Very close to zero. It's only 0.05. It's going to be approximately to be zero. The equilibrium in X direction is now okay. And then summation of F sub Y, this is going to be positive, 2.69. And this is zero. This is minus 20. And this is going to be plus 17.28. So we have this one minus 20 plus this is 7, this is 8, point, this is 9, and this one, that is going to be minus 0.030. That's going to be approximately zero. It's okay. Okay, it's not usually zero because there are the significant figure that we use in the calculation. If you set, you check, and then you obtain the equilibrium, all the calculation that you have done is okay. If not, you don't need to go further. Okay, go back to check everything since the first step. Make sure everything correct. Okay, you cannot process further. If you process further, your result gonna be wrong. Okay, and now you obtain unknown displacement. You obtain reactions, unknown forces, and then you can determine the unknown member force. For the unknown member force, Ajahn have mentioned in the previous lecture. you got to go back to the step over here for the small k step number 4 okay on the step number 4 for example you will know lambda sub x you will know lambda sub y you will know l okay so you take the value of l lambda sub x lambda sub y and use it to determine the member forces now for member number 1 okay you have this one member number 1 member number 1 you have lambda sub x to be minus 0.707 lambda sub y gonna be positive okay that mean just put kid lambda sub x over here lambda sub y over here lambda sub x over here and lambda sub y over here then the degree of freedom that is gonna be this 1 2 and then 3 4 now you just put kid 1 you know kid 2 and 3 3 is 0 and 4 you have 1 millimeter settlement now you put them together you get this one to be 3.8 kilonewton in tension okay just process it this is ae this is l you know l okay this is minus lambda sub x minus lambda sub y positive lambda sub x positive lambda sub y capital d1 capital d2 capital d4 capital d3 capital d4 you get this one for q2 okay again this one you have l equal to 1.2 meter if you remember lambda sub x gonna be minus 1 lambda sub y gonna be 0 so based on this one this is gonna be 120,000 divided by 1.2 and this is gonna be minus of minus 1 and then 0 and then minus 1 and then 0 and this one gonna be what 1 2 5 6 okay this gonna be 0 5 this is 5 this is 6 gonna be 0 this is gonna be d1 this is gonna be d2 now I should say something about this one after you get this one sometimes you don't need to put this matrix multiplication in your calculator this will be what this the first term okay the second term gonna be 0 the third term gonna be 0 the fourth term is gonna be 0 so this one is gonna be 100,000 times 1 times 0.204 and then divided by 1,000 1 2 3 1 2 3 so it's gonna be 100 times 0.204 you have it to be 20.4 in tension okay now this one is in tension coming to the third okay third this is going to be this member and we have the lambda sub x and lambda sub y and that's degree of freedom gonna be d capital d 1 capital d 2 capital d 7 capital d 8 okay and then you put it together you times this one by this number plus this one by this number and then 0 and then 0 you have it to be minus 28.8 now this one is in compression you got to check the equilibrium again based upon the result the small q1 is 3.8 small q2 20.4 small q3 is 28.8 okay you may set summation of x sub x equal to this one okay if you put this one in positive direction that's 20.4 then the component of this one okay this is gonna be for this one 1 1 square root 2 This is 1.2 1.2 change it to 1.1 square root 2 put it in this direction plus 3.8 that's gonna time 1 divided by square root 2 for this one it's gonna be in the opposite direction minus 28.8 and then you know this one that's gonna be 1.2.9435 this one is gonna be 3, 4, and 5 that's gonna be 4/5 you check it this one should close to 0 okay if not you got to do redo the calculation okay that is our first problem based on our PowerPoint okay any question on this one again no question the problem is I should ask you did you review how to use the calculator to do the matrix operation please share your knowledge okay if you don't know about it please share with your friend okay that is going to be our first portion okay class let me take you back to what we left since lecture 15 the example show here is a loop task and then it's subjected to the incline 10 kilonewton force in the analysis we got to project it in the vertical direction 10 times 4/8 and the horizontal direction 10 times p over 5 and then following the global coordinate system local coordinate system the degree of freedom classified to unconstrained and constrained degree of freedom again the light blue 1, 2, 3, 4 gonna be unconstrained and the pink is gonna be 5, 6, 7, 8 the task have 5 millimeter downward settlement then they ask us to determine the displacement also to determine the internal forces actually we can determine the reaction also and then following the same step after we separate the degree of freedom into two group we start by determining the known displacement capital D sub K. Okay, that's going to follow what? Capital D sub K going to follow capital D5, capital D6, capital D7. All of them are zero. And capital D8, this one is downward settlement. So it's going to be minus 0.005. Again, for the known forces. That's corresponding to degree of freedom capital D1 capital Q1 capital Q2 capital Q3 and capital Q4 the component here corresponding to degree of freedom number 1 so it's plus 6 and then this one downward minus 8 D3 and DQ capital Q3 and capital Q4 they are zero since there is no loading over here then after you finish it and make it clearly you have to determine the small k matrix for the small k matrix you got to use the local coordinate such as for member number 1 local coordinate over here you will have lambda sub x lambda sub y positive okay then for this one you have k1 equal to this matrix you may go back to lecture 15 but if you noted you can see on this calculation ajahn include ae in the calculation why because if you include ae in the calculation your calculation gonna be more easier in my opinion and then if the member have different AE the size Most of the time, the member, the bottom chord and top chord, they have the same size, but the vertical and diagonal may be smaller. Okay, by including A E over L in the determining of small K matrix, gonna be more convenient in this manner. And then we have five member. We have small K one, two, K five. And Ajahn have noted that if you have the horizontal and vertical member, the small K matrix gonna have number of zero in the matrix. Now, we got to combine small K matrix into capital K matrix. And again, we gonna use the method called indexing. Okay, we got to use the method called indexing. Based upon this one, let Ajahn show you if you have done it before, you may compare your result with my result. First, I should mention how big is the capital K stiffness matrix. It's going to be checking with the total number of degree of freedom, since we have total of 8. So our matrix gonna be 8 by 8. And then we have separate them into two group. Okay, so the first group is 1, 2, 3, 4. Just put this one. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we have another group that's gonna be 5, 6, 7, 8. Just put this one, 5, 6, 7, 8. And also for this one, let me zoom it out a little bit. That's gonna be 5, 6, 7, 8. And this one gonna be 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, following this one, we going to do again what's so called indexing. We will do indexing. And based upon this one again, we will later partition the matrix into four parts. Now, let us start by capital K1. Okay, capital K1. And let me put this one in the black. This is what? This is row number 7. This is row number 7. We have row number 7 over here. And then from this one, we have 7, 7. 7, 7 is here. 7,680. And then number 8, 5,760. And then number 1, that is going to be over here. Over here, 1 minus 7,680. And then minus 2, minus 5,760. Okay. And if you have the projector, my projector ruler, that's going to help you also. This is going to be 7, 7, 7, 8, 7, 1, 7, 2. Then we go to row number 8. Okay. Row number 8, we start with this one. 5, 7, 6, 0. 5, 7, 6, 0. And then column number 8. 4, 3, 2, 0. And then column number 1. Minus 5, 7, 6, 0. And then column number 2. Minus 4, 3, 20. Okay, now you move to next. Next is going to be what? Next is going to be row number 1. Row number 1 is over here. We start with 7. Minus 7, 6, 80. And then 8 minus 5, 760 and then coming to number one. Okay, this is 780 and then coming here, row one, and then column two, 5760, and then the last one over here, last one over here, column seven again, and then with the row number two, column seven, the first one, minus 5760, and then 8, minus 4320, and then 1, 5760, and this one, 4320. After you finish it, it is your duty to check whether the matrix is symmetric or not. How to check it? Just check this one and this one the same. This one, 1 7, that is row one, column seven, and then this was 7 1. This is row one, column eight, this is 8 1, and this is the same. This is the same. This is the same, and this is the same. You got to check it to make sure each time your index or you add symbol, the matrix, you got a correct result. Okay. Now, let me move to the second one. That's 1, 2, 5, 6. Let me put it over here. Okay. This is going to be 1, 1, 1. And then this is 1 with this one is 1. So this is 1. This is gonna be 780 and then 2 minus 5760 and then 5 minus 7680 and then plus 5760. That's gonna be the first one. The second one we are over here, 2, and then start with 1. That's gonna be minus 5760, and then plus 5 7. Oh, wrong. This is minus. This is 4320. This is 4320, and then 5 over here plus 5760 and then minus 4320. Now you move to number 5, okay, and then 1. Number 5 and 1. Number 5 and 1 start here, minus 7680 and then plus 5760 and then jump to this one, 5 5. It's gonna be 7680 and then this is 5 and 6 and that's it, minus 5760. The last one is gonna be low number 6. Start with 1 5 7 60 and then negative minus 4320 and then this is 5 over here minus 5760 and then the last one 4320. Now you got to check whether it's correct or not. Let me put it over here. It's very dark here. Let me put it over here. You may check again this one and this one. Okay, 1 5 5 1, 1 6 6 1, and then 2 6 6 2, and then 2 5 5 2, and then this one and this one. Second is gonna be okay. It's in symmetry. In symmetry. Okay. You do this one, every one of this one. How come? It's just fixing. Take this one out. Okay.
What mood?
One move.
Okay, is one chain any? Oh, this guy is fishing. Huh. Is one move at all? How come? Hmm. Ah, okay. Now it's going to move to K3. Ah. Do the same thing of the K3. Okay, you just take this one and do it slowly. Hook it like that's one. It's doing 3, 4, 5, 6. Hey, this is going to be easy, Ajahn. Yes, it's going to be easy. 3, 4, 5, 6. 3. Okay, go over 3. And then 3 is over here. It's going to be positive 15,000. And then 4, 0. And minus 5, 5, 5, 3. 5, 3, 15,000. And then 6, that's going to be 0. 4, 4 over here. 0, 0, 0, and 0. And then for this one, 5, 5. You start with this one, minus 15,000. And then this is 0. And then this is plus 15,000. And then this is 0. And then for number 6, 0, 0, plus 0, and then plus 0. Now, you move to the next one for K4. Okay, K4. Let me put this one 7, 8, 3, 4. Put this one 7. Okay, 7 and 7. 7 and 7. This is plus 15,000. And then 8 plus 0. And then 3. 3 is over here. This number minus 15,000. And then this is 7. Oop, I'm sorry. This is wrong, right? No, it's not wrong. 7, 7, 8, 3, and then 0. Then row number 8, 7, 8, and 3, 4. Then going to number 3 over here, 7, and then 8, and then 3. And then 3. And then 4. Okay. And then coming to 4. Okay. We have 7, 8, and 3. And then the last one, 4. Okay. And then we have the last one. We have the last one for this one. For this one, it start by 3. 3, 3. 3, 3, 3, 3, this one, plus 0, 3, 4, plus 0, 3, 1, that's going to be 0, and 3, 2, 0. Now, going to 4, 4, 3, 0, and 4, 4, 20,000, and then 4, 1, 0. And then 4, 2 is gonna be minus 20,000. And then 1, okay, 1, 1. Changing this one to over here. This is 3, 0, 4, 0, 1, 0, 2, 0. Then going to number 2. Number 2 start with 3, 0. 4 minus 20,000 and then 1. 1 2 1 plus 0 and then 2 it's going to be plus 20,000 and that's you do the combination of everything and then you arrive at this loan displacement relationship and for this one again Ajahn already include the term AE so this example have no AE in front of capital K matrix unlike in the PowerPoint now you got to table is good actually you got to draw the matrix is going to be capital Q equal to capital K and capital D that's going to be the matrix that we looking for now we got to put this one to be Q 1 Q 2 Q 3 Q 4 going back over here you have 4 Q as you are known loading then you separate this one and then it's going to be the reaction as going to be reaction Q 5 Q 6 Q 7 and Q 8 that's going to be the reaction on this rule and then you may dot this matrix again this one called column matrix this is the column matrix I put this one is gonna call column matrix now it's gonna be equal to capital K now it's gonna be equal to capital K we got to combine all of this and then we got to put it into eight column and let me put this one 1 2 3 4 and 5 6 5 6 7 and then 8 okay you get to have this one also for this is going to be your matrix and then we have 1 1 2 3 you got to do it 4 5 6 7 and 8 and then you have this one to be 1 2 it's going to be total of 8 by 8 matrix and the last one is going to be over here this is going to be the matrix of 8 by 8 matrix and we call this one is in the form of symmetric matrix okay now you got to time again by capital D we have the column matrix again over here and we have capital D okay D5 D6 D7 and D8 that's going to be capital D5 going to be 0 we have this one 0 0 0 and minus 0.005 D6 D7 D8 minus 0.005 meter and then you have this one to be your column matrix and you got to separate it and over here is going to be D1 D2 D3 D4 you are looking for it now you got to do the summation these two term 7680 7680 you got to have 15,360 this one minus 0 this one zero. This one zero, and it's better if you just do the partition. Do the partition, partition, separate them four at the row and also four at the column. That's gonna help you to combine or do the matrix calculation. Then number five, minus 7, 6, 80, and then this is next plus 5, 7, 60, and then minus 7, 6, 80, and then minus 5, 7, 60. Okay, that's total first eight. You're going to have total of 64. Okay, this is the first. Hey, I think the location of this one is not that nice for me. Then the second one, this is going to be zero. This is going to be 8640 2008 640. Okay, that is 28,640, and then zero, and then minus 20,000 plus 5, 7, 6, or minus 4, 3, 20, minus 5, 7, 6, or and then minus 4, 3, 20. Row number three, zero, zero. This is going to be 30,000, and this is gonna be zero minus 15,000. Zero minus 15,000, and then the last one, zero. Then come over here, zero minus 20,000, zero, and this one, 20,000, zero, 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 and zero. Now, coming to the fifth, minus 7, 6, 80, okay, and then 5, 7, 60, and then minus 15,000, zero, and this one, 15 and 7 will be 22, 22 and 6, 80, okay, and then minus 5, 7, 60, and then zero, zero. Coming to the sixth row, and that is 5, 7, 60, 60, and then minus 4, 3, 20, and then zero, and then zero, minus 5, 7, 60, 4, 3, 20, and then zero, zero. That seven, minus 7, 6, 80, minus 5, 7, 60, minus 15,000, and zero, and zero, and zero, and 22. 22, 6, 80, and then 5, 7, 60. And we have the last one. You got to do it. Minus 5, 7, 60. Minus 4, 3, 20. Zero, 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 5, 7, 60, and then 4, 3, 20. We finish it. And then following this one, and then following this one, you got to be your best to do so. And I should say, typically we call this to be K11. This is K12. This is K21. And this is K22. And then I like you to check the symmetry. Okay. Row number one, column number two, and this is row number two, column number one. Check. Okay, check. 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 Positive, positive, okay. Negative, negative. negative 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 zero 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 and positive. That is nice to have it. Then the second one, zero zero minus 20,000. This is 5760 minus 4020 minus 5760 minus 15,000. Zero 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 and zero. And then check next. Zero zero minus 15,000 zero and zero minus 5760 and then the last one you may check. This gonna be this one and this one. Okay, we cannot check for the hexagonal. We only can check for like I said K capital K I J going to be capital K JI. We call this symmetric matrix. Okay. Now, we got to compute for unknown displacement, the sub U. Based upon this one, you have capital Q1 to be equal to plus 6. This one equal to minus S, this is zero, this is zero. Okay, now you just copy it. This is going to be the way we do the calculation. 6 minus 8, zero, zero, and this is going to be our Q sub. This is the Q sub K, and then equal to this term. You don't need to do the copy. Okay, just said it's gonna be K sub 1 1. And then K sub 1 1 gonna time this one. Gonna time the D capital D sub U. D1 is gonna D1, D2, D3, D4, and then it's gonna be plus. This one K sub 1 2, K sub 1 2, 1 2 3 4, and then it's gonna time this one. It's gonna time D5 0, capital D6 0, capital D7 0, and then this one 0.005. Again, I should note it on the calculation of this one. You don't need to do the copy, okay? And this is gonna be minus 7. Actually, you don't need to write the number. Just put like this one. 1 2 3 4 and 1 2 3, and then you have the ping. 1 2 3, and then 1 2, and then you have the orange 1 2 1, and then you have the green. Okay, this is I like to mention about this one because you don't need to do the computation. Actually, you don't need to put these two matrix in the calculator because of what. If you notice on this one time zero, this one time zero, this one time zero, only this one time this one. So the matrix here, only the matrix here, gonna be equal to this one time zero, this one time zero, this one time. This number is what? This number is this number, okay, minus 5760. This one minus 5 70 times this one times minus 0.005. Then do the same thing. This term times zero. This term times zero. This term times zero. This number. Okay, it's gonna be minus 4320. This one times this one minus 0.005. Then, if you notice, This one times zero. This one times zero. This one times zero. This one. This one is zero. Zero times this one. This one is zero. The same thing. This one times zero. This one times zero. This one times zero. This number is zero times this one. This one is zero. After you do the calculation, you will get the result. This one. Negative is gonna be, let me put this one, it's gonna be equal to positive. More, could you check with me? This is gonna be 28.8 kilonewton, and this is gonna be positive. 21.6 kilonewton. This is zero. This is zero. I'm not sure it's correct or not. It's supposed to be correct. Okay, this one. Now, you have what? You have 6 minus 8, zero, zero. And then you take this one in the opposite direction. You will get minus. 28.8, and then this one 21.6 and zero, zero. Okay, you just take this one and then you get negative 22.8, and this one got to be minus 29.6. Zero, zero. And then this is gonna be equal to K sub 1, 1. And then time D1, D2, D3, D4. Okay. And then following what we have over here, D1, D2, D3, D4 is gonna be equal to this one, K sub 1, 1. Now you got to do the inward, and then time this one minus 22.8 minus 29.6 zero, zero. Okay. I'm not sure it's correct or not, but the result of this one is coming to be minus 1.484 × 10⁻³ meter. And second one, you have minus 3.426 × 10⁻³ meter. The third, zero. And the fourth, minus 3.426 × 10⁻³ meter. And then you may draw the elastic curve of our task. Okay. But for this one, let me take you to a next step, determine the Q sub U. Okay. Q sub U over here will be Q5, Q6, Q7, Q8. Then you have what? Equal to this matrix over here. This matrix over here. You got to make a copy. That is K21. K21 gonna time this D1 to D4. Okay, time D1 to D4. Time this one minus 1.484 × 10⁻³. Second one, minus 3.426 × 10⁻³, and then zero, and then minus 3.426 and then 10⁻³. That's going to be the first term, okay, of this one, this one, and then plus again, this term, Okay, K two time again zero minus point .005. Then this is going to be our next step. Okay, next step. Next step of what? You do the same thing. Okay. Let me put this one. 22, 6, 80, and then this one, and then this one, and then this one, the second row, this one, and this one, and then 4, 3, 2, 0, and then this one. The third, we have king, and then 22, 6, 80, and then yellow, and then yellow, the last one, 4, 3, 20, 4, 3, 20. The problem is going to be the same if you do it. Take this one times zero, this one times zero, this one times zero, and this is zero times this one times this one times the second, this one times the third, this one zero. So the first one is going to be zero, this time zero, this time zero, this one times zero, this is zero times this one. The second one, yellow times zero, this one times zero, pink times zero, and this one zero times zero. Okay, this one zero, zero, zero. This is 5, 7, 60. You have 5, 7, 60, and then times this one minus 0.005. And then this one times zero, this one times zero, this one times zero, this one times this one. 4, 3, 20 times minus 0.005. After you do the calculation, this is going to be calculated by hand. And then you do the calculation for this term. What the result you have? You should get the result of this cube. Okay, it's gonna be a matrix of this one, the result of this one, plus the result of this one. This is zero, zero. This is going to be minus 28.8, and this is going to be minus 21.6. After you do the computation, you will get the reaction, and the reaction going to be minus 8.333 kilonewton plus 6.250 kilonewton plus 2.333 kilonewton and plus 1.75 kilonewton. And then you got to put everything, okay, into your task. Let me take this one. One, two, three, four, five, six, and then halfway over here. And this is about this one. And our task gonna be here. And I should say the task subjected to the force of 10 kilonewton. This is 4, 3, 5. And then what we have over here is the displacement. Okay, this is capital D1 D2, the capital D1 is 1.5 millimeter. That's about this one. Negative. Okay, negative in this direction. And then the capital D2 also negative, gonna be downward for 3. Nearly 5. Okay, this is gonna be the new location of the node here. Then we have the 5 millimeter settlement over here. Okay, this is gonna be 5 millimeter. This is gonna be 1.484 millimeter. This is gonna be 3.426 millimeter. For D3, D3 is 0, only D4. So this is about 3.4. That is gonna be 3.426 millimeter. You guys must show me the results like this one to show your understanding of your calculation. Then you just draw, this is gonna be the pin. This also gonna be the pin and the elastic curve. Just connect the line of the TUS member together. You get the new elastic curve like this one. You got to specify this one and the direction to me. And then you have the reaction. Reaction of what? Reaction capital D5. Capital D5 is negative. So capital D5, this is 5, negative. That is 8.333 kilonewton. And then you have this one, capital D6, Q6, capital Q6. Here, capital Q6. This is gonna be 6.125 kilonewton. And then capital Q7, gonna be here, 2.333 kilonewton. And capital Q8, that's gonna be this one, 1.75. And then you got to check the equilibrium of this one, summation of x sub x equal to, if this is gonna be positive, 2.333. And then you also have this one. This is 10 times 3 over 5 plus 6. Okay, this is gonna be 6 kilonewton. And then minus 8.333 equal to 0. Okay, this is good. Then you have to do the summation of F sub Y equal to this one up positive, 1.75. This one plus 6.25. And then if you put this one in this direction, 10 times 405 equal to 8, minus 8, then this is 0. Okay, it's good results. Okay, next, you can compute for the forces in the TUS member. Now, you are ready for compute the force in the TUS member. Let me focus on this member number 1 and also member number 2 and also for member number 5. Okay. And for member number 5, for member number 5, if you take a look, it's going to be zero force member. Okay, why? Two member connecting together, no applied force over here. The third member gonna be zero force member. We will prove it later. Okay, now Q sub F is gonna be AE over L minus lambda sub X minus lambda sub Y, lambda sub X, and lambda sub Y, and it's gonna time d sub n x d sub n y d sub f x d sub f y and then for member number one we have the member number one in this direction and the node of this one taking over here 1 2 7 8 is going to be 1 2 and then 7 and then 8. So Q1 is going to be 120,000 divided by what we previously has the length of this one. The length of this one. 2.5. Yep. 2.5 is going to be divided by 2.5. Right. No, AE is what? No. Ajahn put thing wrong. AE over L. AE over L is going to be AE over L. AE. AE. AE over L. Yeah, AE over L is going to be this one. AE over L is going to be this one. Okay, this one, 12, is going to be only 1, 2, 0, 0, 0. Okay, and then time for this one, you have lambda sub x of 0.8 is going to be minus 0.8, and lambda sub y 0.6 is less. Minus 0.6 and then lambda sub x 0.8 and then 0.6 and then we have capital D. Okay, we have D what? D we have the direction of this one to be what? In this direction. Okay, we have D7, D8. This is 0. This is minus 0.005. And then D1, D2. D1 is over here. Okay. Minus 1.48410 minus 3. And then D2 over here. Minus 3.42610 minus 3. Then after you put it, this one time, this one plus. This one time this one plus this one time this one plus this one time this one, you will get Q1 to be minus 2.914. Okay, you do the same for this member. This member, okay, this is gonna be 1, 2, and then this is gonna be 5, 6. You will get Q2 equal to 12,000. And this second one, you have plus minus. Okay, that is going to be minus 0.8 plus 0.6. And then check this one, 0.8 and then minus 0.6, and then you time this one to be D5 equal to 0, D6 equal to 0, D1, D2 again. You will get this one to be 10.42 kilonewton. And for Q5, you can prove it to be 0 kilonewton, Q5. And then you may cut this one, okay? And then this one project to be 8 kilonewton. This one project to be 6 kilonewton. And you have, this is going to be your Q1 equal to 2.914 compression. This one, compression also, it's going to be 10.42 kilonewton. You can check this is x This is why summation of x sub y equal to 0. Sorry, sub x equal to 0. Summation cos of y equal to 0. And then you will get the result of this one. Okay, of the high class. And then everything, if they are in equilibrium, you're okay. Okay, so we will not have any question. We have video clip. So go back and take a good look at that video clip. Thank you very much.